Oh, good day everybody, welcome to the Acer channel. And right in today we will be having a look at the ICOM F5022 mobile transceiver. Now this is a mobile unit, which not like the American term of mobile referring to a portable device. In Toyota Arabia terminology, we say a mobile device is a unit that fits inside a vehicle. So it can be configured to either be a base station or a mobile. In this case, we are looking at the IC5022 VHF mobile. This review will also refer to the F6022, which is the UHF version. What we have inside the box, so I get the camera slightly up there. What we have inside the box is a package which has some stickers on and the information booklet. We have a typical ICOM microphone, fist microphone, the bracket with the power cable and some screws for mounting it. We take it out, we can see that the device is in the bottom here. I'm going to take it out so we can have a look at it. There you go. Let's put that aside and have a look at this little device. This is a small device. It is not very big. Typical of ICOM making maybe a mid-sized, not very small device. You can see the heat sinks on the top, enough space for heat dissipation, with obviously space there where the name is, where the PA transistor is sitting on the PC board. It has four allocation buttons on the front, channel up and down, and the power with a volume control just there where the microphone socket is. The speaker is front facing, which is good. It means when you're mounted, the sound will always come from the front. Often the other radios where the speaker sits either on the bottom or the top, is you'll find that the sound is muffled because it has been mounted in such a way that there is no space for the audio to come out. ICOM do this way. They've learned from the past and it seems to work quite well. In this case, there is a BNC on the back of this radio. A BNC for connecting the antenna and also a polarized type connection for the power. There is a additional output socket for the sound, for the audio, so you can connect an external speaker to it. And that is it. ICOM do not make a radio with a... They don't like doing it. Let me rephrase that. I'll get ostracized for saying they do not make. They only make a few devices which I know of that has external accessories. So the accessories are actually behind here. So the accessory connections are behind there. You can do the modification inside and come out, which is like a rubber seal with it. So to make a back-to-back option or interface this into something else, you will have to open the device, which often leads to other problems. Like warranty issues, because then the radio is exposed. So there you go. I think this is a good indication of what the radio looks like. And if you look at the bracket, typical ICOM bracket, there's enough space to mount your stuff in there, and space for enough screws. It has a swivel type design. It is always problematic when that is in position that there is so much space wasted at the bottom. So much space wasted at the bottom. I think they have a reason for doing it that way. But yes, if you use the bracket, there must be ample space to accommodate that with. What I have also found in the package is the mic hook for the microphone. Get supplied with it with a bunch of screws. So yes, there is an installation kit basically for that. It comes with an earthing strap for your mic hook. I think this may be only about a meter long or so, which the idea of this is to mount this to earth the mic hook. There are certain functions which will enable the mic hook to do certain things once you put it on the mic hook. So this is why they have supplied this with. The power cable, as we can see, is also the same polarized type of connection. I think it's about 4 meters long with an inline fuse. I do not like these fuses, it's a glass fuse. But yes, they have not supplied any lugs with this. It is just the open cables on the other end. There is no lugs supplied with this kit. And as you can see there from the inside, just 2 solder terminals. It is nice if the guys give lugs. So once again, thank you for watching. This is the review of the ICOM 5022 unboxing review, just to see what you get in the box and out of the box. Oh goodness, I almost forgot. Here we have the microphone. Just taking it out of the plastic. Comes with an ICOM fist microphone, as they call it. In this case, it's an HM152. Nice positive click to it. Untangled or in its normal curled up state, this will be probably half a meter or so. You can pull it out. I'm not sure what the total length of this is. For the people that know, you can put it in the comments below. With a normal type connector that all the new radios come out with a nice seal around it. I do like that. Nice seal around it. Comes off easy as well, if you know how. Does not come off easy. There you go. The pin is at the bottom. Comes out easy if you know how to. But to make it foolproof, you can push this over here. Take full advantage of this little seal around it. Push it on there. And this will keep everything in position. There you go. It is a nice fit because there are grooves around the connector. There are grooves around it, so it is a good, decent seal, I would say. Fairly water resistant from a splash point of view. And there you go. The ICOM 5022 unbox review. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to see all the videos. Have a look at the others. Please feel free to comment and leave any comments which you think I should look at. Any comments is always good. I will look at any product that you guys feel I should in our industry. Thank you for watching. Have a superb day.